theater and dancing. But later on in life, I thought, no, there's something in those stars that I need to see. And I was accepted at NASA and became that first female African-American astronaut. Along those lines, earlier than that, there was a female named Katherine Johnson. Now, today is February 17, 2019. Katherine was born August 26, 1918. Now, 2018, last year, she was 100. She's still alive today. She was celebrated in the movie Hidden Figures.
Yes, sir.
That came out in 2016. You got to see it. It's a great movie. Katherine was a mathematician. She always wanted to be a mathematician. She always wanted to do math. When she was a little girl, she had to do chores. Washing the dishes, she used to count every dish. Every time on the fork, she used to count every step she made. Steps going into chores. She counted everything. She couldn't help it. She was just a counter. She graduated early. She was very, very intelligent and smart. And she got a degree early in life. She was accepted at the West Virginia University, their signature university. And she stayed there for a while before she married and had children. But after that, she finally got accepted at NASA, which was then called NACA, NCA. Katherine went on to become what they call a human computer. This woman was instrumental in Alan Shepard going into space and coming back successfully, he and his crew. At the time, they had computers doing the trajectory and the splashdown computations. Alan Shepard said, I know that computer you got over there, that big computer, is doing all of that, but I'm not real comfortable with that big computer doing all of that because it makes mistakes and hiccups and things. I want the girl to do my computations and going up there and getting back. She did the computations and he went and came back. He said after she had done that, he says, now I feel better. We're ready to go. That was just one thing that she did. Right now, there's a $30 million building, 40,000 square feet installation, research installation, in the Langley area that is dedicated to Katherine Johnson. She received the highest civilian award from President Obama a few years ago. And she's